I'm Kate Richburg for JewelryTools.com, and today I'm going to talk to you about one of my favorite soldering surfaces, the charcoal block. Now, you guys, using a butane microtorch, sometimes you need a little extra push of heat, and the charcoal block does that for you. I call this kind of the most sophisticated and advanced of our soldering surfaces because most fancier jewelers or more advanced jewelers do their work on a charcoal block. Now, with the butane torch, as you're soldering on the surface of this block, the charcoal really heats up a lot and reflects that heat back up onto the piece that you're soldering. So it makes that microtorch work all that much more effectively, as well as it creates an oxygen-reduced surface, the charcoal does. So you're less likely to get fire scale on your metals as you're soldering, and therefore you'll get a faster and cleaner join with your metals as you're soldering. The thing, though, the stickler about this charcoal block is they can get kind of brittle as you're using it. So I have a little hint here to help you extend the life of your charcoal block. I've got some steel wire here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap that wire or bind that wire right around this block. I'm going to leave a little bit of a tail here, maybe about 3 inches or so, and I'm just going to come around and wrap my wire a couple of times around my block, like so. Okay? Now, I'm going to use my chain nose wubbers here, and I'm just going to bend that wire around the side. Can you see that? I'm just securing it. Now, you don't have to do anything fancy with this, you guys. Just bending that wire around to secure it around the block. And I've only wrapped this a couple of times, you know, around the length of the block, and that's all you really need. And I'm going to do that same thing, you guys, with this first tail, that little 3-inch tail that I left. And see how I'm just using my chain nose wubbers to come in there and tighten that up just like that? That's all you need. Then what I'm going to do is I can come in and cut my extra wire away, or I can just lay it along the side. Either way, it doesn't make much difference. I'll just go ahead and secure it just like that so it's out of my way. Then you can see our wire, it's a little loose here. So I'm just going to come in with the tip of my chain nose and give it a little quarter turn twist. Can you see that there? And what I'm doing is I'm tightening up that binding wire all around my block. And you may be wondering, well, Kate, why the heck are you doing this? Well, let me tell you. As you heat your charcoal block and as you use it, it starts to get brittle, as I mentioned. Sometimes that brittle block can crack. And if everything is already bound together, it's going to hold that block together, and that crack isn't really going to matter so much. So it'll extend the life of your block. So even if your block cracks, it's going to hold together, no big deal. You can keep using it. So the charcoal block, a terrific soldering surface for you to use with any of your soldering torches.